القصص. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. حاميم. والكتاب المبين. إنا جعلناه قرآنا عربيا لعلكم تعقلون. حاميم. By the clear book. Indeed we have made it a Quran in Arabic that you might use your intellect. We find that out of all the languages in the world, Arabic is the only language with such depth, with such wisdom behind it that one word can contain up to 80 different meanings. So we find this is the only language which the Creator could have chosen. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَعْقِلُونَ. So that you would be intellectually stimulated. You'd have to use your brains in trying to fathom the true meaning of the Quran. And indeed this Quran is in the mother of the book, Lawh-e Mahfooz, with us, indeed exalted, full of wisdom. Shall we then take away this reminder from you because you are a people transgressing? Because you're not ready to believe, you're not ready to change? Should we take the Quran away? And how many a prophet have we sent amongst the men of old? And never came there a prophet to them, but they used to mock at him. See, some people say the Quran, you know, is outdated and we should change certain portions of the Quran. And we should change those portions that pertain to women so that people can accept it. Allah says, this Quran cannot be changed. Falsehood does not come to it from behind it or from before it. How dare we say that we should change this Quran or remove this Quran because people aren't accepting? That's not the criterion. Never there came a prophet to people, but they used to mock at him. This is nothing new. Then we destroyed men stronger in power than these, and the example of the ancients has passed away before them. And indeed, if you ask them, who has created the heavens and the earth? They will surely say, the Almighty, the All-Knower created them, who has made for you the earth like a bed, and has made for you roads therein in order that you may find your way, and who sends down water from the sky in due measure. Then we revive a dead land therewith, and even so you will be brought forth from the grave. And Allah, who has created all the pairs and has appointed for you ships and cattle on which you ride, in order that you may mount on their backs, and then you may remember the favor of your Lord when you mount thereon and say, Subhanalladhi sakhara lana haza wa ma kunna lahu muqarineen. Glory be to Him who has subjected this to us, and we could never have done so by our efforts. Wa inna ila rabbina lamunqalibun. And indeed to our Lord we will return. This is the vision of Islam. Allah says, use the worldly blessing. Use the worldly resources. وَشْكُرُوا لِلَّهِ. And thank Allah. What has been modern man's disaster, his tragedy, that he is so busy using the worldly blessing, but he has forgotten Allah. So Allah says, no, you're not stopped from using the worldly blessings. Not that you have to renounce everything good or everything powerful. Use them, but remember Allah. Glory be to Allah who has subjected this for us. Whether a car, whether a ship, whether an aeroplane, whether a train, whatever mode of transport, no matter how sophisticated, we have to thank Allah. Because it was Allah who gave us the intellect to create this. وَمَا كُنَّا لَهُ مُقْرِنِينَ. We could not have done it ourselves. وَإِنَّا إِلَىٰ رَبِّنَا لَمُنْقَلِبُونَ. The true purpose, the true message can never be forgotten, that the journey is to Allah. Right now we are embarking on a lesser journey. And actually the journey is to Allah. We're traveling back towards Him inexorably, minute by minute. Every minute brings us closer to our death, closer to meeting Allah. We find that when the Prophet ﷺ would mount any form of transportation, whether a horse or a camel, he would read Allahu Akbar 3 times, and we should emulate that as well. And then he'd read a very beautiful dua, which was, Allahumma inni as'aluka fi safari hadha al-birra wa taqwa. وَمِنَ الْعَمَلِ مَا تَرْضَىٰ. O Allah, I ask of you in this my journey, goodness and Allah consciousness, and that deed which will please you. Allahumma hawwin lana safar. O Allah, make this journey easy for us. وَطْوِ لَنَا الْبُعْدَىٰ. And lessen the distance for us. Allahumma anta sahibu fi safar. O Allah, you are our companion in this journey. Wal khalifatu fil ahal. And you are the one who will take care of the family that we leave behind. So be with us in this journey and take care of our family. This is the gist of the dua. And when you read this dua, or even if we read Subhanalladhi sakhara lana haza, then it just serves as a brief reminder that let me think about, where am I going? Am I going to a place where I'll be obeying Allah? and thus this dua will be accepted by Allah? Or am I maybe going to a place where I'm going to be disobeying Allah? Remember, inna ila rabbina lamunqalibun. We're all traveling back to Allah. Like it or not, admit it or not. وَجَعَلُوا لَهُ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ جُزْءًا. And they assign to some of his slaves a share with him. People who pray to peers or buzzards for children or for wealth or for any other blessing. Indeed, man is a manifest ingrate. Or has he taken daughters out of what he has created? Because the pagans used to say that the angels are Allah's daughters. And he has selected for you some. وَإِذَا بُشَّرَ أَحَدُهُمْ. If one of them is given the good news of the birth of a girl, that which he set forth as a parable to Ar-Rahman, his face becomes dark and he is filled with grief. Now we find that this expression occurs a couple of times in the Quran, that when one of them is given the good news of a girl, his face becomes dark with anguish and regret. It's as if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala detests this man at this point in his life, that Allah has granted him a living child, a human being to take care of, to bring up, and this is the way he responds. This is his reaction, that we've had a third daughter and a fourth daughter. His face becomes dark and he is filled with grief. See how Allah honors us women. Again and again Allah repeats this metaphor to make people think that why do they grieve at the birth of a girl? And Allah says they're not ashamed. This is their thinking, that they don't want daughters for themselves, but they say that Allah has daughters. Do they wish a creature who is brought up in adornment and who in dispute cannot make herself clear? Now this is a reference to woman's emotional nature. And this is really a beautiful aspect of Islam. That Islam says that every person has been created with certain qualities. The Prophet ﷺ told us, "An-nisa'u shaqa'iqur rijal." Women are the counterparts of men. They're not supposed to be like men. They're different from men. And a woman's emotional nature is essential in the upbringing of her children. If you've seen that, you know, some women, when they're very reserved and they're very cold, and they have a great difficulty communicating affection with their children. And sometimes those children are even emotionally scarred. So Allah is acknowledging woman's emotional nature over here. It's a very tender ayat. A creature who is brought up in adornment, woman's femininity, her love for jewelry, her love for finery, and who in dispute cannot make herself clear. Generally speaking, woman's emotional nature. Look at the love behind Allah's words. And they make the angels, who themselves are slaves of Ar-Rahman, females. Did they witness their creation? That they are saying the angels are Allah's daughters? Their testimony will be recorded, and they will be questioned. وَقَالُوا لَوْ شَاءَ الرَّحْمَنُ مَا عَبَدْنَاهُمْ. They said, if it had been the will of Ar-Rahman, we should not have worshipped them. And many people say this. If Allah wanted me to pray, I would pray. And if Allah wanted me to read the Quran, I would read the Quran. They have no knowledge whatsoever of that. They do nothing but guess. In other words, they have no right trying to put the blame on Allah. That is the meaning of free will. لَا إِكْرَاهَ فِي الدِّينِ. Allah does not force us to obey Him. The choice is ours. Or have we given them any book before this to which they are holding fast? No. They say, we found our fathers following a certain way and religion and we guide ourselves by their footsteps. Oh, it's too much effort to read the Quran. Just do what your grandfather used to do. Similarly, we did not send a warner before you to the town, but the luxurious ones among them said, we found our fathers following a certain way and we will indeed follow their footsteps. We never want to follow our grandfather's way of dress or our grandfather's way of eating, but it's strange that we're happy with his deen and his traditions and rituals, even if they have nothing to do with Islam. See, in religion, people just stop thinking, they stop using their brains. And when it comes to the dunya, we want the latest. The warner said, even if I bring you better guidance than that which you found your fathers following, they said, indeed, we disbelieve in that with which you have been sent. We're not interested. فَانْتَقَمْنَا مِنْهُمْ. Allah says simply, so we took revenge on them. In other words, they were destroyed. Then see, what was the end of those who denied? And there are different forms of denial. We can deny by our words, and we can deny by our actions. وَإِذْ قَالَ إِبْرَاهِيمُ لِأَبِيهِ وَقَوْمِي. Remember when Ibrahim said to his father and his people, Khalilullah, Allah's friend, Allah loves him so much. It's like Allah wants to tell us about him again and again. Remember when Ibrahim said to his father and his people, indeed I am innocent of what you worship. What's the link between the verses? Sometimes we lack the courage to stand up to our parents and tell them that this ritual is wrong. It's not in the Quran and it's not in Sunnah. So Allah reminds us of the story of Ibrahim alayhi salam to teach us courage, to stand up for the truth, not to compromise, ever. Indeed, I am innocent of what you worship, except Him who created me. فَإِنَّهُ سَيَهْدِينَ He will guide me. I will take my deen from Allah and His book. And He made it a word lasting among His offspring, لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ In order that they might return. He taught this to His children as well. Not that He let His children do what they wanted to do. He taught them this truth as well. What truth is this? لا إله إلا الله. None has the right to be worshipped but Allah. بَلْ مَتَّعْتُ هَؤُلَاءِ Allah says, No, but I gave to these and their fathers to enjoy because they had wealth, because they were getting away with everything. They thought they were on the right path. Till there came to them the truth and a messenger, making things clear. And when the truth came to them, they said, This is magic, and we disbelieve therein. And they say, Why is not this Quran sent down to some great man of the two towns, Makkah and Taif? See, this was something that the Meccans could not endure. On one occasion, we find that the Prophet ﷺ's bitterest foe, Abu Jahl, even acknowledged that in my heart, I know this is the truth, but I cannot bear that this honor should be given to the Prophet ﷺ's tribe. And sometimes we find its prejudices that hold us back from obeying Allah. No, if I do this, then I will become like them, become like people that I've despised. It's very difficult to reject tradition. It's very difficult to break away from prejudices. But Allah says, these people say, why hasn't this Quran been sent down to some great man of the two towns, Makkah and Taif? We don't even know the names of the leaders of Makkah and Taif. We've heard of the names of a couple of them, Abu Lahab and Abu Jahl. But we don't even know the names of any of the leaders of Taif. See, people's perception and people's vision is always distorted. Is it they who would portion out the mercy of your Lord? So they want to decide now who's going to receive prophethood? It is we who would portion out between them their livelihood in this world. And we raise some of them above others in rank so that some may employ others in their work. The whole existing system in the world, everyone can't be rich. Everyone has been created in a different situation. وَرَحْمَةُ رَبِّكَ خَيْرٌ مِّمَّا يَجْمَعُونَ Risk is in Allah's hand. We're not dividing risk between people. And Allah reminds us, the mercy of your Lord, this Quran, this Sunnah, this Deen is far better than all that they're collecting. If it's their wealth that's keeping them from obeying Allah, then they are in a true delusion. وَلَوْلَا أَن يَكُونَ النَّاسُ أُمَّةً وَاحِدًا Were it not that mankind would have become one community, لَجَعَلْنَا لِمَن يَكْفُرُ بِالرَّحْمَنِ لِبُيُوتِهِمْ سُقُفًا مِّن فِضَّةٍ We would have provided for those who disbelieve in Ar-Rahman silver roofs for their houses and elevators whereby they ascend and for their houses doors of silver and thrones on which they could recline and adornments of gold. There's so much sadness in Allah's words that had all these disbelievers been given all this, Allah knows that everyone would have started disbelieving in Allah. Everyone would have disobeyed Ar-Rahman. Allah doesn't say disobeyed Allah Ar-Rahman. That on one side we have Ar-Rahman who is inviting us to His love, to His mercy, to His treasure. Yet we turn away. Yet we want the life of this world. Allah says, In kullu dhalika lamma mata'ul hayati dunya. Their posh lifestyles, their elite surroundings, their grandeur, their splendor, their pomp and circumstance. All this is nothing more than the enjoyment of this world. A brief mirage, an illusion which is not going to last. وَالْآخِرَةُ عِنْدَ رَبِّكَ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ And the hereafter with your Lord is for the Allah conscious. See, the dunya is something that Allah doesn't value. He despises the dunya. So He gives it to everyone, those whom ask and those who don't ask. Like if your child comes up to you and you've got some, you know, colored marbles in your hand, he wouldn't say, I'm not going to give you the colored marbles. You'd give the colored marbles. You wouldn't care whether the child loses them or the child takes care of them, but you wouldn't just hand your little infant child the diamonds that you have. وَالْآخِرَةُ عِنْدَ رَبِّكَ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ The jewel of the hereafter will only be given to those who sought it, who valued it, who treasured it. ومن يعش عن ذكر الرحمن نقيد له شيطانا فهو له قرين. Whoever turns away blindly from the remembrance of Ar-Rahman. Turns away blindly. What remembrance is this? This Quran. We're not interested in the Quran. Oh, the Quran is so frightening. I'm not ready for it yet. I'm too young for the Quran. Whoever, young, old, male, female, Muslim, non-Muslim, whoever turns away blindly, without thinking about it, without even reflecting upon it, just he's not interested in changing, so he just turns away blindly. From the remembrance of Ar-Rahman, we appoint for him a devil to be a friend to him. And indeed, these devils hinder them from the path of Allah, but they think that they are guided aright. This is their true tragedy. That then they go on willfully straying. More confusions, more delusions, more deceptions. Zulumat ba'duha fawqa ba'd. Darkness upon darkness of ignorance, of superstition, fears, prejudices, biases. All of these darknesses engulf this person then. And this devil is merely leading him further astray. Hatta idha ja'ana. Will that help him? Will that devil be able to stop him from dying? No, till when he comes to us. Qala ya layta bayni wa baynaka bu'd al-mashriqayn. He will say to his devil, would that between me and you were the distance of the two easts. How bitterly he will regret that devil then. And Allah says, فَبِئْسَ الْقَرِينَ. What an evil friend. What friend has Allah given us? What friend has Allah told us to adopt? وَاصْبِرْ نَفْسَكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ رَبَّهُمْ بِالْغَدَاةِ وَالْعَشِيِّ. Keep yourself with those who call to their Lord morning and evening, seeking His pleasure. وَلَا تَعْدُ عَيْنَاكَ عَنْهُمْ. Don't turn your eyes away from them, desiring the life of this world. وَلَا تُطِعْ مَنْ أَغْفَلْنَا قَلْبَهُ عَنْ ذِكْرِنَا. Do not obey the one whose heart we have made heedless about our remembrance. Someone who knows nothing of the Quran, not interested in knowing the Quran. So Allah says, the choice is ours. The Prophet ﷺ told us, Al-mar'u ma'a man ahabba. A man will be with the one he loves. So if we want to see what our level of iman is, our level of taqwa is, look at your best friends and you'll find out. It will not profit you this day because you did wrong and you will be sharers in the punishment. You and your friend. Afa anta tusmi'u summa? Can you make the deaf to hear? Someone who doesn't want to hear, someone who is not interested in hearing, can you force him to hear? Can you guide the blind or him who is in clear error? And even if we take you away, we shall still take vengeance on them. Some people say, well, we've seen those who pray and we've seen their actions. They won't be asked about their actions. They'll be asked about their own actions. Allah says, even if we were to take you away, we shall still take vengeance on them. Tilka ummatun qad khalat laha ma kasabat wa lakum ma kasabtum. That was a nation who has passed away. You're not going to be asked about what they did. And for you is what you have earned. Or if we show you that wherewith we threaten them, then indeed we have perfect command over them. فَاسْتَمْسِكْ بِالَّذِي أُوحِيَ إِلَيْكَ إِنَّكَ عَلَىٰ صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ. So hold fast to that which is revealed to you. Indeed, you are on the straight path. In other words, Allah says, ignore their foolish objections. Focus on this Quran. Cling to the Quran. How do you hold fast to something? That you let go of it when you're tired? No. When you hold fast to something, you can't dream of letting it go. And this Quran, we cannot simply form a contact with it in Ramzan and leave it for the rest of the year. This has to be a lifelong contact, a daily contact. Cling fast to that which is revealed to you because you are on the straight path. And this book will teach us how to live our lives. وَإِنَّهُ لَذِكْرٌ لَكَ وَلِقَوْمِكَ. This is a reminder for you and your people. وَسَوْفَ تُسْأَلُونَ. And you will be questioned about it. You'll be asked about whether you read the Quran, studied the Quran, acted upon it, and conveyed it. And ask those of our messengers whom we sent before you, did we ever appoint gods to be worshipped besides Ar-Rahman? وَلَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا مُوسَى بِآيَاتِنَا. And indeed we sent Musa with our signs to Fir'aun and his chief. He said, indeed I am a messenger of the Lord of the world. But when he came to them with our signs, إِذَا هُمْ مِنْهَا يَضْحَكُونَ Behold, they laughed at him. And not a sign we showed them, but it was greater than its fellow. And we seized them with torment in order that they might return. And they said to Musa, O you sorcerer, call to your Lord for us, according to what he has covenanted with you. Indeed, we shall guide ourselves aright. Sinan's essence doesn't change. People say, O you Maulvi, pray to your Allah. This is what these people used to say as well. But when we removed the torment from them, behold, they broke their covenant. And Fir'aun proclaimed among his people saying, O my people, is not mine the dominion of Egypt? And these rivers flowing underneath me? That I am the global cop because I am the superpower? Do you not see them? Am I not better than this one who is despicable and can scarcely express himself clearly? Allah says, this is nothing new. Messengers have been denied before you. Why then are not golden bracelets bestowed on him or angels sent along with him? Muslim youth question that if Islam is in the right, then why are the Muslims the world losers? Allah says, Thus Fir'aun befooled his people and they obeyed him. They fell into the trap and they judged by worldly standards. Indeed, they were a people who were disobedient to Allah. So when they angered us, we punished them. فَأَغْرَقْنَاهُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ And we drowned them all. It's as if Allah is just contemptuously dismissing them. That when they angered us, Allah gave them chance upon chance. But when they still denied, then Allah just swept them all in the sea. And we made them a precedent and an example to later generations. And when the son of Maryam is quoted as an example, behold your people cry aloud and they say, Are our gods better or is he? They quoted not the above example except for argument. Nay, but they are a quarrelsome people. What happened was that on one occasion, this pagan came up and asked derisively, If the Christians worship Christ, why are our gods bad? Allah says, they are simply a quarrelsome people. There's no sense in their arguments. In huwa illa abdun an'amna alayh. What was Isa alayhi salam? He was no more than a slave. We granted our favor to him, and we made him an example for the children of Israel. And if it were our will, we could have made angels to replace you on the earth. People who say, no, he was a god or he was an angel, Allah says, no, he was a human being, because he was sent to human beings. وَإِنَّهُ لَعِلْمٌ لِلسَّاعَةِ And indeed he shall be a known sign for the hour. Therefore have no doubt concerning it, and follow me. This is the straight path. In other words, that Isa alayhi salam's second coming will be before the day of judgment. And this is confirmed by over 100 ahadith. And when he comes, Christianity will be finished. He will kill the Dajjal. وَيَكُونَ دِينُ لِلَّهِ And all religion will be for Allah and Allah alone. Follow me. This is the straight path. And let not shaitan hinder you. Indeed, he is for you a plain enemy. And when Isa came with our clear proofs, He said, I have come to you with prophethood and in order to make clear to you some of that in which you differ. فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَأَتِيعُونَ Therefore fear Allah and obey me. We fear Allah and we follow the Prophet. Indeed Allah, He is my Lord and your Lord, so worship Him alone. This is the straight path. But the sects from among themselves differed. So woe to those who do wrong from the torment of a painful day. Do they only wait for the hour that it shall come upon them suddenly while they perceive not? Al-akhillau yawma'idin ba'duhum li-ba'din aduv illa al-muttaqeen. Again Allah reminds us the importance of our friendships in this world. Best friends that day will be enemies one to another except the Allah conscious. In other words, we need to make sure that if our friends are not obeying Allah and we're meeting them with the intention of influencing them for Allah's sake, that's fine. But be careful lest they end up influencing us instead. And that while we think that we're trying to guide them, and they end up misguiding us instead. Allah says, all friends that day will be enemies one of another. People who helped each other in disobeying Allah. إِلَّا الْمُتَّقِينَ Except the Allah conscious, except those whose relationships were based not upon ulterior worldly motives, but for love of Allah. يَا عِبَادِ لَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْكُمُ الْيَوْمِ وَلَا أَنْتُمْ تَحْزَنُونَ O my slaves! Who are Allah's slaves? عِبَادُ الرَّحْمَنِ الَّذِينَ يَمْشُونَ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ هَوْنًا وَإِذَا خَاطَبَهُمُ الْجَاهِلُونَ قَالُوا سَلَامًا The slaves of Ar-Rahman. Those who walk on the earth softly, in gentleness, in humility, who use the earth's resources, don't abuse them. And when the ignorant speak to them, they say, peace be on you. Ya ibadi, O my slaves, we need to become ibad al-Rahman in this world. It'll be too late to claim that title in the hereafter. No fear shall be on you this day, nor shall you grieve. You who believed in our signs and were ones who surrendered, who obeyed, it wasn't just talk. Udkhulu al-Jannah, enter paradise. You and your mates in happiness. Trays of gold and cups will be passed around them. There will be therein all that their own selves could desire. وَتَلَغْضُ الْأَعْيُنُ, all that eyes could delight in. And you will abide therein forever. This is the paradise which you have been made to inherit. بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ, because of your deeds which you used to do. Therein for you will be fruits in plenty, of which you will eat as you desire. Everyone will be in Jannah? No, fariqun fil Jannah wa fariqun fil Sa'ir. One group in Jannah and one group in Hellfire. Innal mujrimina fi adhabi jahannam khalidun. Indeed, the criminals, not the non-Muslims, not the kafirs, the criminals, those who disobeyed Allah, will be in the torment of hell to abide therein forever. The torment will not be lightened for them, and they will be plunged into destruction with deep regret. وَمَا ظَلَمْنَاهُمْ. You read this and you think, how unfair, how could Allah punish them? Allah says, no, we did not wrong them. They wronged themselves. وَنَادَوْ يَا مَالِكْ لِيَقْضِ عَلَيْنَا رَبُّكَ. They will cry out, O Malik, let your Lord make an end of us. People of hell will call out to the keeper of hell, the angel at the entrance of hell, O Malik, just tell Allah to finish us up. When do we pray for death? When we have no hopes. When we think that we cannot bear it anymore, people say, I wish I could die. That's what they'll wish that day. قَالَ إِنَّكُمْ مَاكِثُونَ. And grimly he will reply, indeed you will live forever. No going back. Death coming to you from all sides, but no one will die. No one's torture will be released. Indeed, we have brought the truth to you, but most of you have a hatred for the truth. So if we hate the thought of Allah in this world, then we need expect nothing but hell in the hereafter. Alhamdulillah. Or have they plotted some plan? Have they got some plan that on the day of judgment they'll have a mutiny or a rebellion or something? Then we too are planning. Or do they think that we do not hear their secrets and their private counsel? Yes, and our messengers are by them to record. Kiraman katibin. Say, if Ar-Rahman had a son, then I am the first of Allah's worshippers. Subhana Rabbis Samawati Walad. Glorified be the Lord of the heavens and the earth, the Lord of the throne. Exalted be He from all that they ascribe to Him. Fadharhum, Allah says contemptuously, just leave them alone. To speak nonsense and to play. In other words, these eloquent debates that they have produced, disproving the existence of Allah, says just leave them talking their rubbish. وَيَلْعَبُوا, and let them go on playing, because that's what they're doing. They want to have a good time, they want to enjoy their life. That's why they've come up with these arguments. So leave them to speak nonsense and to play until they meet the day of death which they have been promised. How ironical. They don't even want to think about the day of judgment, and Allah says it's their day. The day when they will be questioned. It is Allah who is the God, the only God in the heavens and the only God on the earth. Ilahun comes from Aliha, to astonish. Ilahun, that astonishing being. Laysa kamithlihi shay. There is none like Him. Don't compartmentalize Allah, that I'll remember Allah when I go for Umrah, and in my office I don't need to think about Allah, and I can cheat, and I can be as dishonest as I like. What has Allah told us? فَأَيْنَ مَا تُوَلُّوا فَصَمَّ وَجْهُ اللَّهِ. Wherever you turn, there is the face of Allah. We can't elude Him, we can't escape Him, we can't hide from Him. He is Allah in the heavens, and He is Allah in the earth. And He is the All-Wise, the All-Knower. And blessed be He to whom belongs the kingdom of the heavens and the earth, and all that is between them, and with whom is the knowledge of the hour. وَإِلَيْهِ تُرْجَعُونَ. And to Him you shall be returned. And those whom they invoke instead of Him have no power of intercession, except for those who bear witness to the truth knowingly, and they know. And if you ask them, who created them? لَيَقُولُنَّ اللَّهِ. They will surely say Allah. فَأَنَّا يُؤْفَكُونَ. How then are they turned away? incredulously Allah, they know that Allah created them, they know He is Rabbul Alameen, still they are not ready to obey Him? And how then are they turned away from the worship of Allah? And Allah has the knowledge of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam saying, O my Lord, indeed these are a people who do not have Iman. Fasfah anhum, so turn away from them. Waqul salam, and say peace. Fasawfa ya'lamun, soon they will come to know. Don't go on and on arguing with them and trying to prove it to them. Tell them the message and then enough.
Turn to Allah, He's never far away. Put your trust in Him, raise your hands and pray. Ooh yeah, Allah, guide my steps, don't let me go astray. You're the only one who can show me the way. Show me the way. Show shine.